everyone, this is Arnout, whizbiz.com, and let's talk a little bit about these so-called brass threaded inserts that can be melted into a 3D printed object to facilitate, for example, the fastening of screws for a lid. I myself have also used these little things with great pleasure and success. However, I've never ever simply thought about using them for something completely different than fastening the lid on my printed casings. But before we go into that, let me first give you a bit of context. Over the years, I've created quite a few parts that can be used with the Fischer Technique construction system. And a special category are the spoked wheels and gears. A recurring problem with these parts is how to attach them to the 4mm metal axis of the Fischer Technique system. If the wheel is closed in the middle and large enough, a normal Fischer Technique clamp like this could be used. However, this hub cannot be used for decorative spoked wheels or small diameter gears. In addition, PLA and PETG material is too brittle to print these clamps properly. The material is not tough enough to print the clamping fingers. These break off very quickly. Here are some of my experiments with that. I've even tried printing the hub from flexible TPU material, but so far this has not really been very successful. An alternative would be to clamp the axle of the printed wheel with a Fischer Technique collet, such as this one. Then you would only have to print the threaded part in your own 3D part, and you could use the very strong injection molded nylon part from Fischer Technique for the other part. This is an option for wheels with a smaller diameter, but unfortunately the depth of these collets is relatively large if you would like to use them for small wheels. In my search for an alternative firm fixing method for the self-printed wheels, I also experimented with tapping 2.5 or M3 threads in the material of the printed shaft on the wheel. The idea was that the wheel could be connected firmly to an axle without slipping by tightening a small headless Allen hex screw. And I've even printed the shaft completely solid with 100% infill to make the thread as strong as possible. This proved to be an easy solution for many decorative models. I've already printed these wheels for several customers who are using them in a decorative fashion on, for example, train models. However, the problem is that you can only not tighten the locking screw too much. Well, you can do it once and then, well, the thread is gone. It's clearly to understand that if you print it with PETG, the plastic will not be strong enough if you want to eliminate any slipping of the axle when the wheel was subjected to greater torque and greater mechanical forces. So if you need gears in a more mechanical way without any slipping of the axle, this was not the final solution. It's a good method for attaching a wheel to an axle with a shallow mounting depth, but the thread for the screw in the plastic is simply not strong enough and will quickly break when tightened too much. Another idea was to use metal flanges like these. They could be used in larger wheels and gears, but unfortunately, 21.5mm is already too large a diameter for the smaller wheels, and they will be way too visible on wheels that have a small center, like spoke wheels. So I started looking for possible metal alternatives that could be incorporated into or onto the final 3D printed wheel. For example, something like this, of which I could imagine that the nut part might possibly be attached in some way into the final 3D printed wheel. The disadvantage of this specific thing is that each insert requires further processing. Because the hole with the thread on one side has to be drilled out to 4mm to facilitate the axle. Well, then perhaps this thing that I also found online could be useful. You could meld it in and lock the ripped parts, I presume. but that melting will have to be done at a very precise angle or the wheel will wobble. So to get that at the right angle, you would probably need to make a special tool for it. And in addition, the Allen screw will end up very close to the surface of the wheel, probably. So it might be difficult to tighten it. Furthermore, this thing seems to be quite expensive and difficult to obtain, so in my opinion, they're not really the useful, cost-effective and reproducible solution I was looking for. While I was searching and puzzling, I thought of these well-known threaded copper inserts. After all, my main requirement is that for a good tight attachment to the axle, the screw must run in a metal thread instead of in the 3D printed PLA or patch G material. And of course, these threaded inserts would fully meet that requirement. I decided to give it a try and added a small bus to the wheel and to give it a little bit more material to melt the insert in. And to avoid the molten material to flow inside, I melt these inserts in with an axle in the wheel like this. And since the tip of my regular soldering iron never touches the plastic, I don't have a special tool for this. I know they exist and I'm curious to hear about your experiences with them, so let me know in the comments. The enormous advantage is that the angle of melting is not extremely critical. It can deviate by a few degrees without any problems. And that's not something that does apply to the possible metal shafts we saw a moment ago. With these parts, the angle must be exactly in line with the wheel axle. You probably need to make a special tool to align that. So I'm very happy with this simple and dead cheap usable ID. The result really exceeded my expectations. The Allen screw can be tightened very hard, allowing the wheel to be fixed very tightly to the axle. This is of course much stronger than the thread that's tapped directly into any 3D printed material. So there you have it. I myself haven't seen these inserts used like this before, so I'm very curious to hear if you think this ID might be useful for you too. Let me know in the comments with this video. And don't forget to check out my other videos if you found this tip useful. And if you want to stay tuned, you might even consider subscribing. So for now, I'm looking forward to seeing you with my next video. And until then, I say, happy hacking!